Hello and welcome to this video tutorial, brought to you by tastytutes.com. In this video, we are going to take a look at the Adobe Illustrator interface. I'm going to show you around and introduce you to some of the things you need to be aware of. Now, I am currently using Illustrator CC for a Mac. If you're using an earlier version, or Windows, some things may be a little different in parts, but in principle, it should be the same. If you have Illustrator open and wish to follow along, you will need to first come up to Window, scroll down to Workspace, then scroll down and select Essentials. Then, to make sure you end up with the same setup you see here, we must again go to Window, Workspace, and then scroll down and select Reset Essentials. This will then set the interface to the Essentials default layout, and you should have something that looks like this. What you will come to learn later on is that you can customize this layout, but what would help right now is for you to have the same layout so you can follow along with me. Now, if for some reason you don't see the same as mine, don't panic, it's not a problem, just follow along and you should be fine. Now, on a Mac, by default, the application frame is switched off. Some of you may prefer to have this on and some of you may like this off. So let me show you what this is. If I come to Window and scroll down to Application Frame, we can see that there is no tick next to this, as it's currently set to off. If I click this, we can now see a solid grey background. This is the application frame. If I turn it off again, Windows, Application Frame, we can see the desktop. My personal preference is to have the application frame on, so I'm not distracted by the desktop background. So, this is Adobe CC, and with CS6 and CC, we have this dark interface. If you're using an earlier version, you will be looking at the light interface. Now, if for whatever reason you wish to toggle the interface color, if you come to Illustrator on the top bar and scroll down to Preferences and select User Interface, you can toggle the lightness and darkness here. I'm going to go with medium dark. So to begin, I'm going to open up a document. To follow along, you can also open up this document. This can be found in the Introduction folder in the Project folder. Now you can download this folder for free. The download link is in the description. So I have my Project folder here on the desktop. When you have the Project folder, simply open it. Then click on Introduction, Interface Introduction, Versions, and select the version of Illustrator you're using. In my case, it's CC. And open the interface introduction file. This file is going to help to demonstrate various functionality of the program, which we are going to be covering a little later on in this video. So, as you can see, this is a document and it contains four artboards with an object on each page. Also, we have some artwork elements in the pasteboard area. Okay, so let's take a closer look at the interface. On the far left, we have this tall, slim panel. This is the Tools panel and contains all the tools that can be used in Illustrator. And as you can see, we have lots of icons. To activate the tool, we simply click it or press one of the many shortcut buttons on the keyboard. We know which tool is active because it has a highlight square behind it on the Tools panel, and also you will notice that the mouse cursor will change, indicating which tool we have active. In Illustrator, we will be using many tools, and most tools have their own unique mouse cursor. Now, if we look carefully, we can also see that some of the icons have little white arrows in the bottom right corner. If we click and hold on the icon, this will reveal more tools in that set. For example, if I click and hold on the pen tool, we can see an extra 3 tools within that set. If I click on the shape tool, we can see a variety of shapes that can be created very easily. And if we move our mouse cursor over the tab on the right, we can expand the tools panel out, which can be very useful. And to remove this, we can simply click the X in the top left corner. So keep in mind that some tools work in sets. Now, if we take a closer look at the bottom of this panel, we can see two overlapping squares. One appears to be a block and one appears to be an outline of a square. Now, if you're new to Illustrator, you may not be familiar with this. What this represents is the fill color and the stroke color of an object on the canvas area. The top square is the fill and the background square is the stroke. So right now we can see that the fill color on the top is white and the stroke color is black. Now, if I come over to the canvas area and select an object, to do this, I will first need to choose the selection tool. This tool is located at the top of the tools menu and is recognized as the black arrow. With this active, let's select this yellow circle here. Then you can see that the fill color and stroke in the bottom of the tools menu has changed in accordance to the selected object. We can see the fill color is yellow and the stroke is orange. This is important because it helps tell us that this object is just one object and not two separate objects. For example, with the object selected, I can click and move this around like so. I'm just going to undo that and put it back in place. And if I come over and select another object, we can see the fill color and stroke color will change again. Now, if you look closely, just above the fill and stroke color on the tools panel, we have this little button here called swap fill and stroke. And if I press this, it's going to swap the stroke and color fill like so. So very easily, we can swap the fill color and stroke color. Now, to the left of the swap fill and stroke, we have another little button, and this is the default fill and stroke. If I press this, it's going to set my fill and stroke squares to black and white. Though keep in mind, if you have an object selected on your canvas area, like I have this circle selected here, and press it, you will see the object has changed to black and white with a default stroke applied. So I'm going to undo this, click off the object to deselect, and click on the default fill and stroke button. And now we are back to the default black and white stroke and fill. So as you can see, the tools menu is currently in two columns. If we look closely up to the top left of the tools panel, we can see these little arrows pointing left. If I come and click this once, we can change the panel to a single column. And if we press this again, we can go back to the double column. For the duration of this course, I'm going to click this and set my tools panel to a single row. Now, if we move to the top of our window, we can see the standard toolbar across the top. From here, we can access various properties and controls, but we are not going to touch on that too much right now. Just under the top toolbar, we have the control panel. Now, this control panel is really useful as this will display various properties of a particular tool or object you have selected at any given time. So right now, we can see some properties here. If I close the document, we can see that it all disappears. And that is because now we have nothing going on. If I open up the document again, and I can do this easily by coming to File, Open Recent, and selecting the file, we can see the control panel kick into action. You will soon realize that this is one of the most key panels in this program, and as you use Illustrator, you will be referring to this control panel a lot. So let's take a look at how it works. So right now, I don't have anything selected. I'm going to choose the selection tool from the top of the tools menu and select an object on the canvas area. Let's select this blue circle here. Now, you will see the control panel change in accordance to the object. Just like earlier, we can see at the bottom of the tools panel, the fill and color stroke has changed, but also we can see this on the control panel. If we click down, we can access the swatches panel and change the color of the fill and the stroke very easily. Also, here we have the stroke property. Here we can easily toggle the stroke size. And also, I can adjust the variable width from a choice of options. If I come across, I can also change the brush definition and even toggle the opacity of this object. So I'm going to undo all this and deselect the object by clicking off it. This time, I'm going to select the text tool from the menu. This time, in the control panel, we can see some new properties. We have properties for font choice, font style, font size, and some formatting options. All of which I can use when I add text to the canvas area. So keep in mind as you use your tools to keep an eye on the control panel, as this is really useful. Moving over to the right-hand side, we have another slim panel. Now, like the tools panel over on the left, this contains an array of sub-panels that are represented by these icons. What you will soon discover is that these panels, like the control panel, are essential in order to produce work in Adobe Illustrator. In order to have a swift workflow in this program, it will help to have a comfortable setup of these panels. Now, in Illustrator, you can arrange these panels in various ways. I'll be demonstrating how to do this in the next episode and recommending an effective setup, though what you see here is a default setup. Now, as we click down the panels on each icon, we will begin to reveal the panels. For example, we have color, swatches, brushes, and stroke. Now, these panels contain various tools and properties regarding objects on the canvas. Also, if you look carefully, these panels also include sub-panels as tabs. For example, on this stroke panel, we also have the gradient panel and the transparency panel. If we come down and click on the layers panel, we can see that all our objects in the document are existing on one layer. And I can toggle the visibility of this. And if I click on the artboard tab, we can see that this document contains four artboards. And if I click once again on the icon in the panel, this will disappear, giving us full visibility of the canvas area. Now, if I come to the very bottom of the window, we have this thin strip. This also contains some useful tools. If we look over on the far left, we have the magnification of our document. We can use this to zoom in and out of our document, like so. To the right of this, we have the artboard navigation. We can use this to quickly maneuver through the document to a particular artboard, or this will give you a clear indication of which artboard you are on at any given time. So next, I want to touch on document tabs. Now, what are document tabs? Okay, so currently we have this document open, and if we look carefully in the top left corner, just under the control panel, we have a tab that shows a document name. Now, sometimes you may find yourself using multiple documents at any given time. For example, let's quickly create a new document. I'm going to come to File, New, and just click OK. And there it is. And let's make one more. And we have another. Now, look again closely at the top left, just under the control panel. And this time we have three tabs. Now, we can click these to navigate to other documents. If I click the far left tab, we are back to our first document. And if I quickly select an object and press Command-C to copy, I can click on the third tab to go back to the new document and simply paste in the object into the canvas like so. So when we start to use multiple documents later on in the course, we will be using document tabs in this way. So I'm going to close these two docs down by clicking the X on the far left of the tabs until I am back to my original document. The last thing I want to talk about here is the canvas area. When you create a document, you will have a white area which represents your artboard size and a grey area around the canvas. As you can see, we have four artboards sitting on the grey area. The grey area here is called the pasteboard. We can put any artwork we want on this, which we don't want to include in our main composition. This is pretty handy if we want to keep bits of artwork on the side to use later. In my example, we can see I have some vector artwork sitting in the pasteboard area here. So that's a brief overview of the Adobe Illustrator interface. In the next video, I will be taking a closer look at the work panels, where I will be showing you how you can customize your panel layout to get a more comfortable workspace. So I'll see you in the next video.